Hey everyone, just coming live with the beef burger recipe posted up online. So let's start off with the onion and garlic. The pan on a low heat. Finely dice your onions. Two cloves of garlic. Crush them using the knife and then just slice through. Now I'm just going to sprinkle a little bit of salt on the garlic. Rub it with the blade of the knife, making it into a nice little paste. Just make sure that way you've got an even amount of garlic through the whole mix and not just garlic in one part. Okay, fry pan, little touch of oil, literally a little touch. I'm going to go in the onions. You don't want a harsh fry on this. Nice and light, you just want to soften the onions and garlic down. There you go. And with them onions, I'm going to add a little touch of thyme as well. And a little bit of black pepper. You got your beef mince. So we're going to add the cumin and paprika into there. Plenty of salt. Salt helps the meat bind together instead of using like a flour or an egg. So that way we're losing an allergen. Plenty of pepper. Start working this together a bit. You've got to be quite firm with the meat. So obviously you want to bind that mince together. The onions are sweated down nicely. I'm kind of like these cool, it's better. But for this video, I'm just gonna put back in, straight into the mix. If you allow them to cool properly, it'll stop your mince from cooking. But while we're doing this. So now we've got the ketchup and mustard going into the bowl. We're going to work that neat now, making sure everything's all the way through, nicely incorporated. Should be slightly wet and quite paste-like, but it should come off the bowl nice and easy so it's not sticking to the sides. Good massage. See how that mix is now coming together quite nicely. Take it onto the board. Put that in there. Now, your pâtés. That's a fair ball. We've got two beef eggs there, okay, here we go. I'm just going to season them up again, just on the outside of the meat this time, like you would with a normal burger. Now they can be made up, you can make as many of them up as you want, let them set in the fridge. The longer the better, really. But we're just going to carry on here. So, come on, nice hot pan. A bit of oil in there. should be nice and hot now. Nice and covered and sealed on both sides now. I'm going to pop these into the oven, 180 degrees for around 10 to 12 minutes until the cook's through into the middle. You can leave a cake if you want, but it's a bit of supermarket mint, so I don't really know where about the animal it's come from, so I don't really trust it as much, so I wouldn't leave a supermarket mint pink. That's what we can see in a bit.
Hi guys, we're back live again. Just going to get the burgers out now.
There we go. And we're going to turn these over now. I'm going to glaze them with some cheese.
Well, that's all going on now. We're just going to do a couple of little bits to finish them all off. So we've got some smoked bacon. Fire that off. I'm going to make a little bit of a burger sauce because we're all missing the good old Big Mac. So we've got some ketchup there. Got a little touch of onion. Unfortunately, I've not got any gherkins or capers, but if you've got some of them, they'll be great in this. Some garlic. Some garlic. Some smoked paprika. If you haven't got smoked, normal fine. About a quarter of a teaspoon in there. So you've got some mustard. Two teaspoons, give that a little mix. A little touch of salt, some pepper, some mayonnaise, about 2 tablespoons of mayo. Some oregano.
And there we go, guys. There's your Big Mac sauce. Before I come on, I made some chips. So we've boiled them up for about 10 minutes first. Drain them off, let them steam dry. And then a tiny little bit of oil over them, just coated them. And then baked them, so they're not deep fried. Quite healthy, there's hardly any oil on them really. Put that to one side for a second. Our brioche bun. A little bit of the sauce on the bottom. Nice bit of leaf. We'll get our burgers out. Bacon on top there. Well, a nice big dollop of the burger sauce over the top. And there we go. Nice beef burger and chips with your burger sauce. Enjoy.